What is product management, my product journey, and how to stay marketable in the field? If you're looking to join tech or make a lateral transition into the field, this web series is definitely for you. So what exactly is product management? How does it fit into technology? Atlassian describes product management as an organizational function that guides every step of a product's lifecycle, focusing on the product and its customers first and foremost. To build the best possible product, product managers advocate for customers within an organization and make sure that the voice of the market is heard. Now, the next question you have to ask yourself is, what exactly is a product? We're going to mostly be talking about virtual products. So virtual products are offerings or services or experiences such as education and software. So the first type I want to talk about is what's called a convenience. So a convenience or convenience product are purchased frequently with little planning or effort. This type of product is widely available, it's easy to obtain, and typically has a lower price. So digital technologies change the meaning of convenience by making many types of products and services available on demand through software applications. Next, you have what's called a specialty or a specialty product. It's a niche product that has features that appeal to a specific group of customers. In technology, this category includes vertical market software such as real estate or banking applications. This type of product requires more targeted promotion to reach the right people. Digital marketing approaches provide new ways for companies and successfully reach and engage specific target audiences. So the last one we're going to talk about is called unsought products. Now, unsought products have little or no proactive customer demand. This category includes new products and products where the direct benefit to the customers is relatively low. So because customers don't perceive a need for these products, the offer and its benefits must be directly promoted to potential customers who are looking to use, you know, the particular service. Now, new technology products focus on innovators and early adopters to gain momentum and influence others. We're going to solely be talking about software as a service products, virtual products, as compared to physical products like cars and, you know, anything that you can pretty much possess physically. Another big question a lot of folks will have is, do you need technical skills? And the short answer is no. You don't actually need technical skills in order to become a product manager or an analyst, a product owner. But what you do need is the ability to understand your engineers or the people who are building the product. You need to be able to at least get to the high level and adopt the idea behind the product that you're going to be working on. In product management, the biggest thing is being able to be the voice of the customer. But you also have to be able to consider the fact that the customers are not the only one who have a stake in the product. You also have your business. You also have the designers and the researchers who are also at the voice of the customer. You then have your engineers who are building the software. You need to be able to translate between all three of these in order to build a successful product. Now, when you're considering the customer, you also need to be able to make trade-offs. Sometimes there's things that the business may want to move forward in a certain direction in which the customers are not ready to move towards. So you need to be able to make the choice in terms of what is best for all parties involved. Now, with that said, another thing that you're trying to achieve is the highest return on investment or the most cost saving or whatever it is that your KPIs and metrics are in order to be able to build that successful product. So I said something key there. I talked about return on investment. Now, when it comes to product management, you need to be able to continuously build your product. And that does take money. So when I say it takes money, what it is it takes an engineer to sit down and be able to solve your problem by building exactly what it is that you and your team are trying to achieve for your customer. If you have, let's just say, a feature that you're building and you get with your engineers and they estimate the amount of effort that it's going to take to build that said feature, let's just say it costs $1 million. And, you know, based on that estimate, you're only projecting to make back $250,000 in a year. That's probably not a good return on investment. Whereas if you're talking about a feature that your engineers are estimating it may cost $200,000 and you're expecting to make $1 million off of that within the first year of launch, that's a great return on investment in some eyes. So you want to be able to make sure that whatever you're building is actually going to yield a good return. Now, in product management, you have to take the initiative to build a business case around the idea or the new feature that you're going to be building for your product, or simply even just the product itself. Maybe you have an MVP, a minimal viable product, for those who don't know, and you want to be able to take this to somebody and get funding for it. You could be an entrepreneur, so to speak, and you want to build a product. But again, we're going to stick to the corporate version in which you're a product manager or product owner, and you're looking to, again, scale that product. So in this case, yes, you do need to build a business case around the idea that you're trying to develop. You need to prove to some VP out there or anybody who's in control of the money that it's going to take in order for you to build the idea. That you need to be able to develop these skills in order to be a successful product manager or product owner. Now, one of the things that I've been extremely excited to hit on, and I figured most people will find this extremely valuable, is my product journey. There was a point in time when I had no clue what product management was. So I want to tell you exactly how I got my foot in the door. So maybe you take some valuable lessons away from what I experienced, and it may be just your ticket in to getting into product management. So how I got my foot in the door, how did I get into technology all the way to where I am today in product management? You know, it starts out in fourth grade, coding, and I fast forward, going to college career fairs, landing my first internship, all the way to where I am now as a product owner. Well, my story is a bit different than most people. I did start coding in the fourth grade. I stuck with technology all the way through up until the point of me starting as a computer. It wasn't until I had jumped into a user experience course, not ideal for computer science majors, by the way, they typically don't teach these things. I actually picked up this course as a part of a technical writing program in which they offered UX and other aspects of design, product, learning about Agile. Went to a local college and career fair, and I was simply looking for an internship as a software developer or engineer, something along those lines. And as I was looking and trying to get more and more accustomed, I realized, you know, my resume might not be set up for these jobs. And so I went back, you know, cleaned my resume up, figured out what my skill set was, and I went to the next college and career fair. But this time around, I was much more ambitious just about being able to talk to people, use my ability to network, find different opportunities that may exist. And sure enough, I actually found the perfect opportunity just by speaking to a recruiter at more than one booth. They originally showed up at the College of Engineering, and then I followed them all the way to the College of Business later that day. So the first time that I was actually offered an internship, they gave me an offer between becoming a software engineer or interning as a intern product manager. So at the time, I had no idea what product management was. I'm like, you see all this technology on my resume. What does that have to do with managing products? I'm thinking merchandise. But I was actually explained exactly what product management is, mostly along the lines of what I've already explained to you guys. And I jumped right in. So when I had started my internship, it was a lot of learning and just being able to deep dive and understand how exactly I was sitting in the middle of all three of those that we talked about earlier. Again, the business, the customers, and the engineers or technology that's being used. And as I had jumped into this, I was very eager and very hungry just to be able to solve problems. That's at the basis of product management. It's really about solving problems for the people who are using your product. Getting into more into my journey, I'm just sitting there and thinking to myself, how did I land this perfect opportunity? Like, how am I able to jump right into a field that's tailor fit just for somebody like me who I can understand technology, but I'm much more passionate about solving the problems for the people who are using it. After the internship, I was given a job offer, starting salary at like $75,000, and just thinking of, you know, how much money I was making, I realized technology, you can make just as much money as the engineers. And nobody really told me that through college. Nobody told me that there were other things in technology that could make you a lot of money and you can be just as passionate about. After the internship, like I explained, I got a job offer, and that really started my product management career. Now, I started as an associate product analyst, but it didn't take any more than about 2 months for me to elevate into the position of a product owner. And I was able to help JCPenney, the company I was working at the time, I was able to help them deliver one of the most valuable features or work on a product in which kept the company alive at the time. JCPenney was going through a lot of financial problems, and they were looking to find what's the next best thing for them to be able to stay alive as a company. So we're going into late 2019, heading into 2020, just before the COVID-19 pandemic. We're working on this curbside pickup experience. I'm working with the mobile apps team. I'm focused on the mobile web experience, and just being able to be the front runner, the person owning this product and this new feature. We were able to deliver it on time, just ahead of that COVID-19 pandemic. And it is a very vital reason why that company is still alive today. So my tips for breaking in the product. You need to explore different markets. First of all, before you think of How am I going to get in the product? Think of all of the different types of products that we talked about earlier. Explore the different markets. Discover innovative products that you might find interesting. Research. Be able to network. Find people who are doing the job. Clean your resume up. Study product interviews. And learn how to own a product. There's plenty of different resources out there for, you know, how exactly am I going to own this product and take it from point A to point B. There's also certifications, which are not required in product management. But I do think it'll give you a strong basis for understanding exactly what product management is, or at least product ownership. Now, the next thing I wanted to talk about was how I stay marketable in my career. In terms of me staying marketable, I think it has everything to do with the idea of keeping that customer first and just being able to solve their problems expeditiously, being able to understand what the business also needs, being able to understand my engineers, what they go through, what's their day-to-day like. And just from there, I'm, you know, just keep advancing. That's exactly what it means to be in product management, is to understand people, understand their issues, and understand how to better serve them at the forefront of everything that you do. So with that said, we're gonna wrap up, but I do want to just give you guys a quick takeaway. If you are looking for resume services, if you're looking to jump into product management and you have no idea where to start, please come to Figures, come check us out. We have plenty of career services to offer you all. I wish you best of luck, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.